everybody. This is Algebra 1 with Mr. Peters. Today we're going to be talking about solving two-step inequalities and graphing. But we're going to really pay attention to the graphing part. So let's get started. There's two different cases when we talk about graphing, everyone. There's when we have a closed circle on our graph and an open circle. And when it comes to a closed circle on our graph, what's going to happen is we're going to have an endpoint, right, that's filled in, and our graph or arrow is either going to be going to the right or is going to be going to the left like I drew. And the inequality symbols, because there's more than one, that gives us these closed circles on the graph is going to be the greater than or equal to sign and the less than or equal to. All right, so it has to be or equal to for the graph to be a closed circle. Now, on the other end, we have the open circle, and this is when there's an open circle on the graph. We are not going to fill it in. And this is how it's going to look once we draw it on a number line, right? It'll be an open circle, either going to the right or the left, depending on the inequality sign. And those two inequality signs are going to be our greater than and our less than. So there is no or equal to when it comes to the open circle. All right, so two-step inequalities, what are they? So two-step inequalities are just inequalities that takes or requires two steps to solve, similar to two-step equations. So with that being said, we're going to use those very same steps, meaning we want to isolate the variable, right? We want to locate the variable, isolate it, and then solve, right? So we know we're solving for this x, and my first thing that I'm going to want to do is to get it by itself. So we're going to subtract 8 from itself, right? Because that's the opposite of adding 8, right? Plus 8. So we subtract 8 from itself, and then we're going to go on the other side of the inequality symbol and do the same thing to its like term. So after our first step, everyone, we now have negative 7x is less than or equal to negative 7, right? But we're not done here yet. No, we have to still get this x by itself. And when I look at it, negative 7 and x, they're being multiplied by each other. So if I'm working backwards, I'm going to want to divide by negative 7 so that I could get my x by itself, right? But there is a very important rule right here, and that is, guys, when we multiply by a negative x, we have to flip our inequality symbol. So if you're wondering why it turned around, that is the reason why. So now, instead of x being less than or equal to 1, we're going to have x is greater than or equal to 1. All right, so how do we actually graph this inequality now that we got our answer? So when we look at our graph, what we want to do is make sure that the number in our inequality is on that graph. So we're talking about the number 1. So I'm going to label this from negative 3 to positive 3. We just want a good range of numbers so we know what's going on, okay? And I'll start off with 0 in the middle. So we label this graph now, right? And now we want to talk about how do we actually graph this inequality. So this is what we're going to do. First thing, guys, always pay attention to the number in the inequality. So we're talking about the number 1, right? And we're going to shade it in blue so this really sticks out. So that means I'm going to put a circle on 1. Now, when I pay even more close attention to my inequality symbol, I notice that it's or equal to. So that means we're going to fill this circle in. All right? And please understand that just because the inequality is pointing towards 1, that's not what determines which direction we're shading towards, okay? We have to read and understand the inequality. So if we look at it, it says x is greater than or equal to 1. So we want to shade in a direction where the numbers are greater than or equal to 1. And if we look, that's going to be to the right, towards 2, 3, and so on, right? Because we're not going to try to put all the numbers on the number line. That's crazy. All right, so let's scroll on down a little bit, and let's look at about a few more graphing examples to make sure we know how to graph our two-step inequalities. All right, so our first graph, we're going to graph x is less than negative 2. So with this, like I said, we're going to try to number this from negative 5 to about 0. The range really doesn't matter, but you want to have at least, you want to at least go up 2 to 3 numbers after the number you graph and 2 to 3 numbers under. And I'll explain what I mean, right? So we have negative 5, right? That's where we start off. So if you look, right, we're going to be graphing at negative 2. But if you look, I went about 2 to 3 numbers up and 2 to 3 numbers down, right? Just so we could get a good image of our graph. And we know, like the previous problem, our circle is going to be on negative 2, right? So I put my open circle there because I know that's the number we're talking about. And then when I look even closer at our inequality symbol, it's a less than sign. So I know it's not going to be a closed circle. It's an open circle. And when we read the inequality, it says, hey, x is less than negative 2, so we should know that the numbers less than negative 2 are going to be towards the left, those numbers further away from 0. So we'll leave that circle open, and we're going to shade towards the left. And we have graphed x is less than negative 2. Now let's say we wanted to graph another inequality that said x is greater than or equal to 3, right? So we're gonna take approaches the same way. So let's start off by numbering our number line, right? So I'm gonna put 3 in the middle, right? We're gonna go up about 3 to 6, and then we're gonna go down till about 0. So we got a good range on our number line, and now we're gonna go and graph at 3. We're gonna place our circle at 3. So I place my circle at 3, and I understand that, hey, this has a or equal to sign under my inequality, so it's gonna be a closed circle, right? Yeah, it's gonna be a closed circle. So we close our circle now, and then we're gonna look back at our inequality and read the statement. This says that x is greater than or equal to 3. So the numbers that are greater than or equal to 3 are going to be 4, 5, 6, and so on. So as a result, I'm going to shade towards the right. All right, and then we're going to finish off by putting a little arrow. And we have graphed x is greater than or equal to 3. Thank you guys so much for joining us today. This is Algebra 1 with Mr. Peters. We're going to ask that if you guys liked this video, if you found it helpful, and to subscribe to our channel for more videos in the future. Thank you.